knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
With a better understanding of nouns in Latin, we are ready to look at other parts of speech. But as we will be using these parts of speech to form sentences, it will be a good idea to briefly discuss the basics regarding syntax or word order in Latin. We mentioned previously that Latin is a highly inflected language. This means that certain changes are made to the dictionary form of most words to indicate variations in their grammatical function. The word inflection comes from the Latin inflecto, inflectere, meaning to bend or to modify. English words are inflected for number, so in English, car becomes cars, if going from singular to plural. Verbs are also inflected in certain tenses, like how I work becomes he works, I worked, or they are working. This applies to comparatives, like tall, taller, and superlatives, like tallest, and in some personal pronouns. He went to school, so I went with him. But that is more or less the extent of inflection in the English language. To compensate for the loss of a full system of inflection, English must rely on a rather rigid order of words in order to make sentences totally clear, while Latin finds this completely unnecessary. Look at the following examples. English says, the soldier rides the horse. If I said, the horse rides the soldier, that would be ridiculous and totally change the sentence. But in Latin, we can do precisely that. In fact, we can say the exact same thing in six different ways. Look at this sentence, which translates to, the sailor praises the queen. Latin can shuffle the word order in any way without altering the meaning of the sentence. Nauta reginam laudat. Nauta laudat reginam. Laudat nauta reginam. Laudat reginam nauta. Reginam nauta laudat. Reginam laudat nauta. This is not an exaggeration. These all mean precisely the same thing. The inflection makes it possible to clarify what the subject is, even if it's moved from its usual place. The word's endings make their function within the sentence absolutely unmistakable. If you're wondering what the point of all this variation might be, since the most stressed words in Latin are the first and the last, moving the words around simply shifts the emphasis from the subject to the verb or to the object, which can add subtext to the sentence. Let's see a more complete example of typical structure in a Latin sentence. The smallest sentence that is possible in Latin will be a single verb. To any verb, we can keep on adding more and more details with any desired word order. As we said, usually we will find the most stressed words at the beginning or at the end. Often the verb is the most stressed word and is therefore frequently placed last. Volare is an infinitive which means to fly. If I say volat, this means it flies, probably referring to a bird or an insect, since humans do not literally fly. Now let's add a specific subject. Aquila volat means the eagle flies. We can modify the subject with an adjective. Pulcra aquila volat means the beautiful eagle flies. Now we can add what is called an apposition. Pulcra aquila avium regina volat. The beautiful eagle, queen of birds, flies. As a quick note, classical Latin did not use commas, but textbooks do use them for better comprehension. We can add an ablative of means. Magnis alis pulcra aquila avium regina volat. The beautiful eagle, queen of birds, flies with large wings. Then we can use an ablative of place. In aere, magnis alis, pulcra aquila, avium regina, volat. The beautiful eagle, queen of birds, flies in the air with large wings. Let's add a place as well. Ad flumen in aere, magnis alis, pulcra aquila, avium regina, volat. The beautiful eagle, queen of birds, flies with large wings to the river in the air. And just one more detail. Trans montes ad flumen in aere, magnis alis, pulcra aquila, avium regina, volat. The beautiful eagle, queen of birds, flies with large wings over the mountains to the river in the air. So that's a brief introduction to word order in Latin. With sentence structure better understood, we are ready to continue working through the parts of speech. So let's return to that by tackling a big one, verbs.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.